His name isn't a household word, but many of the hotels he's built are, especially to South Florida. Morris Lapidus practically single-handedly changed the look of American architecture. His work is now being taught and studied all over the world. After designing more than 700 hotels worldwide, he's enjoyed financial success, but as Channel 4's Ileana Bravo tells us, it's taken over 30 years for the critics to give him his due credit.
Fabulous 50s. Kids were dancing the creek, cars double with submarines, and backyard bomb shelters bought peace of mind. At the same time, Morris Lapidus was changing the look of architecture forever, starting right here on Miami Beach.
I was an architect who dared to do something different. Actually, I was a store designer. By a series of lucky accidents, I finally latched on to the Fontainebleau, which really was the first building that I ever built. I never built buildings or designed buildings.
Not bad for a first try. The building itself broke new ground, but the critics buried Lapidus.
I didn't dare take a building and curb it. No one ever curbed the building. They said, "You're ridiculous." The public loved it. The architects hated it with a vehemence that I have never experienced. They just tore me to pieces.
It was the public's love that paid off. The Lapidus offer was glamour, and they were ready for it.
I had to look for some source of information to help me design the Fontainebleau. And that source of information was the movies.
Busby Berkeley musical extravaganzas gave Lapidus the inspiration to go wild.
These big stairways and spiraling things with beautiful girls on them. And I said, "Think of an idea of a nice curving stairway."
An idea that gave birth to the famed Fontainebleau lobby stairs. Designed strictly for decoration and as a gimmick to let women show off their dresses, it was dubbed the Stairway to Nowhere.
Here I've designed something which actually doesn't make sense, but it makes a great deal of sense.
Three stairs into the old main dining room were also designed to elicit stairs.
When the people came on the platform, there they were in their best bib and tucker and gowns and so on. And the maitre d' would greet them and then walk them down three steps. These steps have been here now for 36 years. And nobody has said to me, "Why did you make people walk up and then come down?"
The answer? Drama. As were his columns, fine antiques, and what Lapidus dubbed cheese holes. America's first taste of design just to be whimsical. The hardest part was convincing hotel owner Ben Novak that they were Novak's ideas.
I said, no, I want to think of something different. And one day he called me in New York and said, "Morris, I got it. Let's do a half circular hotel."
The two feuded over almost everything, including who actually designed the hotel.
But Novak discovered, and I still say, I had to design the hotel. He couldn't design an outhouse.
Few of Lapidus's touches remain inside the hotel today. His seating section became an escalator, and wallpaper hides his wood. But thousands have unknowingly tread on his trademark.
What I did was put the bow tie in the floor in the Fontainebleau. They think it's part of the ornament, but that's my signature.
After the Fontainebleau, the jobs never stopped, starting right next door with the Eden Roc.
The owner, Harry Musson, said, "Look, I'm not going to tell you how to do it. I want you to build a hotel so that when they walk in, they'll fall flat on their ass."
Instead of the movies, Lapidus looked to the classics for inspiration.
You can see the traces of what it was, but it no longer is.
Another stairway to nowhere adorns the Eden Roc lobby, as do columns attached to floating shapes, a modern-day sundial, and some of the classic statues Lapidus purchased. But some of his glamorous touches have vanished.
The Renaissance coffee shop is now Sadie and Billy. Oh, times change.
His biggest challenge there came after the hotel was completed. The Eden Roc was owned by Harry Muffson, ex-partner, current competitor to Ben Novak, who had a bizarre request for Lapidus.
He says that, blankety-blank, ex-partner of mine, Muffson. I want to cut off the sun from his pool, so I want you to build a hotel on the edge of my property, so that the shadow of the building will block out his sun, and that will be my final revenge.
Lapidus refused, but Novak got the building built, taking away their sun as well as their business.
During the winter, that wall casts a shadow over the entire pool.
Muffson came to me and said, you've got to get me a pool in the sun.
Lapidus built a pool on the far end of the property. A bar surrounding it enjoyed a view of swimmers through windows in the pool. His next job was the old Americana, now the Sheraton Bell Harbor.
I had a hole in the ceiling of the lobby. I was open to the sky and I closed it with glass. Within it, I planted a tropical rainforest and actually arranged for slow rain mist to come down.
In its place, today stands a revolving sculpture. Only his sweeping staircase around it remains the same. His trend-setting use of curves changed the look of Miami Beach and opened a new door for architecture, only now being recognized and appreciated.
Either my genes or God or destiny allowed me to live long enough to know what I had done through the years.
Lapidus has designed at least one hotel on almost every Caribbean island and has hotels all over the world, including Africa. A few of the local buildings Lapidus designed include Gusman Cultural Center, Seacoast Towers, the old Miami Beach Theater for Performing Arts, and the Alexander Hotel, where Nelson Mandela stayed this week.